Hey girlfriends, welcome back to the channel for another video. If you're new here, my name is Jerrica Mycia, but all my friends call me G. And if you're a returning subscriber, thanks for coming back this week and clicking on my face. And if you haven't already, girl, go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up, like, share, comment, subscribe. Do not forget to follow me over on Instagram for all of my fabulous updates, and come back each week for weekly uploads. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you girls a few pieces that I have just been obsessing over, okay? And I thought you girls would be interested. Now, some of these pieces I have here with me, some of them I have them like on my mental wish list, but I'm just like manifesting them into the wardrobe. And y'all know how I am. When I say I want something, I manifest it and bam, we get it. So I thought this would be cute and fun to share. And also, I want to hear what you guys have been obsessing over. What are you manifesting into your wardrobe? So comment down below and let's just chat about it. Y'all know I'm nosy. I be wanting to know. Y'all be shopping too, and I love when y'all tell me the things that you guys are purchasing, so I don't feel like the only one that has a problem, okay? So we're all in this together. So if you're interested in this video, girl, keep watching. Okay, first on this list here, girl, it is the Fenty Skin, and this is the butter drop. So this is the body butter. Oh my god, y'all know when it comes to my skin, I do not play, okay? I exfoliate twice a week, we moisturize, we keeps it together. So I've been seeing everybody on YouTube, Instagram raving about this body butter, but the person who sold me was Chelsea Janae. Sold me. I was watching her vlog and she's talking but putting on this body butter, and I'm like, oh ma'am. Same day, y'all, I went out to Sephora to get it, okay? So y'all, this is the best body butter I have ever used in all of my life. It just makes my skin literally feel like butter, okay? And I love the fact that it gives my skin like this very shiny gloss without making me feel too oily, because that's my problem with a lot of body butters. It just makes me look way too oily. But hold on, it has like this really nice can you guys see that? It has this really nice consistency. It's kind of thick, but not too much. And y'all, it's just so good. So good. Look at this. Look how, it's just, girl. Listen, come back. If you have not purchased this, y'all, you need it. I know y'all tired of me saying that you need it, but you need it, girl. Because at first I was like, everybody was talking about it. Even Aaliyah, she was just saying how good it was. And I'm like, I got enough body butters, but if you don't have this one, girl, what are you doing? Look at that. It's just so pretty. It makes your skin just look so supple and just so healthy. And I feel like if you do not moisturize, if you're not a person who moisturizes, because I don't know your reasoning, but you should start, because you know you want to keep the skin skinning, girl. And this right here, one step, you're good. You're good. So I have been obsessing over this. I carry this everywhere with me. I even asked Will around the holidays, will she come out with like a larger size, because I need more of these. I want to keep one in my purse and I want to keep one at the house. So I'm obsessing over it, girl. Okay, so next on the list, I also have something here from Fenty Skin, and this is the Instant Reset Overnight Recovery Gel Cream. Now, you can use this overnight, but lately I have actually been using this under my makeup as like a moisturizer, because I like my makeup to look like skin. I don't want you to walk up on me and it's like very cakey or powdery. So I've been using this under my makeup, and oh my god, the instant hydration it gives my skin is just amazing. And I feel like it goes well under my makeup because it is like a gel base. It's not too greasy, but it still gives my skin this very hydrating, moisturizing effect. Now, one thing I did realize with all the Fenty Skin products, they do have this very light scent. I usually do not use products on my face that have any type of fragrance or anything in it. However, these two, the fragrance on these are very, very light. They do not bother me. I do have very sensitive skin, and I've been using this. I haven't had any breakouts, any irritations or anything. The way that the body butter smells, girl, it just smells so good that I wish I can get it in like a perfume or a body spray. It's very, very subtle, but it's like clean and just, it's just so good. Like, even smelling it right now, it's so, so fresh and so good. Now, if you're a person who have sensitive skin, I will probably go in store and maybe get a tester before you go ahead and commit to buying the full thing to see if you have a reaction, because I know a lot of people do not use things that have fragrances on their face. Okay, now this one, it has a nice consistency. I'm gonna put it here. And it's just so good, y'all. Under my makeup, it just gives me the moisture, girl. Because I usually use a rose gel under my makeup. Oh, look at that. But yeah, I usually use like this rose water gel moisturizer under my makeup, and I wanted to try something new. So I've been loving this so far. I'll just keep you guys updated to let you know if I have any breakouts or any problems with it. But right now, girl, I'm just loving. It's the hydration for me, okay? It's the hydration for G. Okay, so I've been wanting to try a new foundation, but I didn't know what foundation to try, because if we've been honest, I do not watch makeup videos anymore on YouTube. I don't know what's new out there, girl. When I go in Sephora, I just get so overwhelmed. So I was scrolling on Instagram one day, and this girl was doing a foundation tutorial, and she was just raving about this foundation. So I picked it up, and it is by Rare Beauty. I don't know if you guys ever tried it, but girl. And this is the Liquid Touch Foundation. I got my color in the 460 warm. I'm gonna link everything that I can down in a description box. Now, this foundation, a little goes a long way. Anytime I'm picking a foundation, I want my skin to kind of like show through my foundation. I don't use a lot of foundation. That's why I make sure without makeup, I'm constantly taking care of my skin, using SPF, using vitamin C, just making sure that my skin look its best so I don't have to put on a lot of makeup. This foundation, a little goes a long way. You can literally dab and blend that out, then I would suggest going back in to add more if you need. The first time around, girl, do not use a lot, because it'd be a lot. Now, what I love about this is very, very light, and it comes with, hold on, let me see. It has a applicator like this. I thought that was so cute, because me, I usually just use my beauty blender, but I could just like, you know, swatch it on and keep it moving. I'm loving this. It makes my skin look so beautiful. My skin still shows through the foundation. It was so easy to match, girl. I literally went in the store, looked at two different colors. It was this one and one above this one. And I was like, oh, perfect. Because a lot of these foundations, girl, they just, you have to mix too many colors just to get your regular color. And that's just not my vibe, okay? I like my makeup process to be very easy, because if we're being honest, putting on makeup is just like, girl, just like, take me now. I just hate it. It's just so long and just sometimes very aggravating. And I don't have time to be mixing foundations to get my regular color, the color that fits me. So I'm loving this right now. And when I'm not using this one, I'm constantly using my Maybelline Fit Me foundation. But right now, this is my fave. It was $29 and it was just worth every penny. I'm obsessed, okay? Next on this list, I have something from Amazon, and these are shoe inserts, like foot pads. Now, I'm gonna put them on the screen so I don't have to show you guys, hold them up. These foot pads, I have been on the hunt for a nice cushioned foot pad, because I have so many bomb shoes, y'all. Like, just shoes that I'm like, oh, and at this point, I feel like I'm collecting shoes and they're just there to be there, just for me to look at, because they're so uncomfortable. If you know European shoes, they're not always comfortable and they're too expensive for me not to be wearing these shoes, girl. I need to get my cost per wear. So I was like, you know what, I had enough. I'm ready to pull out all my cute shoes. I'm tired of just like looking at them in my closet and not actually wearing them because they're uncomfortable. So I found these foot pads on Amazon. I'm going to link them down below, and in the future they will be linked in my Amazon storefront. So found these shoe pads, and oh my god, I have issues with like heels and the balls of my foot. It just be like all the pain is right there, just like killing me. Girl, if you put this cushion in your heels, get a pair of heels that's just like so uncomfortable. Put this, the key to these pads, you have to place them in like your target area, the area that I guess all of the pressure of your foot is on. When I promise y'all, these pads made my most uncomfortable shoes comfortable. And I'm just like, chef girl, yes, I hit gold with this. Now, they are a little pricey. They're $15. However, I promise you, girl, you will not regret it. I promise you. I just popped these babies right in my shoe, and girl, I just was like, wow. They're very comfortable. So the thing is this, once you place these pads in your shoes, wherever you're gonna keep them, they will not move. It's gonna just stay where it needs to be. And girl, I promise you, these will make your most uncomfortable shoe comfortable. Now, one of my friends, she had the Saint Laurent, I think it's Opium heels. Y'all know the heels with the Saint Laurent logo as the heel. Those shoes are hell. Hell. They're so uncomfortable. That's why I sold mine. They're so uncomfortable. But she tried these pads and she was like, gee, I wore them shoes all night. Like, when I tell you, my most uncomfortable shoe was probably my Dior booties and my Ferragamo heels. So uncomfortable. But slide these babies right on in, and girl, I have just been clicking and clacking around, okay? she's back in business, okay? So the bomb shoes, you guys will be catching them all over the gram and everywhere else. So if you're not following me on Instagram, do that now, girl. Now, speaking of my Ferragamo heels, I have them here. Now, these shoes, I have had these shoes for years, and I have not been able to wear them because they were so painful. Like, I'm talking about I couldn't even walk from here to the door in these shoes. They're so painful because all of my pressure was just on the ball of my foot, and I just could not do it. Girl, you guys will be proud of me. I actually wore these shoes last night to dinner. When I tell you I had no issues, I'm just galloping around, girl, just comfortable, okay, with the shoes. And these, I don't know the name of them. They're not on here. I forgot, y'all. These shoes came out so long ago, and they just so damn good, girl. And see, I placed them right here, girl. Look at this. Look at that heel. Y'all know I love a good heel, honey. Look how pretty this is. And it has this thing where you wrap it around the ankle. Now, one thing I love about this shoe, as you can see here, it's kind of like a silhouette. So it's like, it doesn't cover my whole foot. So it's kind of like a little sexy little cutout. It just makes everything just look so sexy, so pretty. And I'm just so happy that I didn't sell them and I'm able to actually wear them now, because I love them, girl. And a lot of you, I post these on my first TikTok. If you're not following me on TikTok, girl, what are you doing? She's figuring it out. She's doing it. Y'all been asking. I'm finally on TikTok. I post these on TikTok and a lot of you actually went out and found these shoes. Literally so quick. So if you're looking for these shoes, if I can, I'm gonna link some down below. I don't know what size is. I'm gonna just try to find some and link them down below for you guys. But you can probably find these shoes now, because these came out like I think they showed on the runway in 2014, but they wasn't released until like 2015, 2016 ish. So these shoes you might can get for maybe $100, $150, and I paid full price. Ugh, I hate that for me. But I'm just so happy that I have them and I can actually wear them now. Look at that velvet, girl. That is just so pretty. Ugh, so gorge. But yeah, shout out to the shoe pads, because girl, she's back in business. All right, so I guess I'll just keep showing you guys the things that I already have sitting right here with me instead of going down my list. So for my fall fragrance, I have been obsessing over the Saint Laurent Libre. And you guys know I love Saint Laurent. Saint Laurent is my favorite fashion house, and I just love all that they do, girl. I live, especially for old Saint Laurent, like early 2000s, 1990s. I live for the moments, girl. But Libre, girl, I'm late to the train. One thing about me, I'm getting more into fragrances because I'm not really a fragrance girl. I get headaches and I get tired of scents very, very easy. So I was just a little hesitant to purchase this, but I did. Now, another tip would be, I purchased this full size bottle for like $50. If you can, buy your fragrances. I say this in my New York video, but buy your fragrances in the airport. They have like those little shops where you can buy gifts, girl. I got so many different fragrances, full bottles, and my total came up to like $175, and I think I got like 4 fragrances, girl. Anywho, girl, this is literally like the fragrance that I have been loving, and I don't know about y'all, but I sprayed away, girl. I'm obsessed. It's not overbearing. It's very, very sexy. It's warm, and I just feel like this is perfect. I was wearing this kind of in the summertime, but I feel like right now I'm just drawn to it a little more because the seasons is changing, and I'm just like, I love this for me. Like, I want to try, there's another one. Is it Black Opium or something like that? I don't know. I know it's another one somebody told me about. If you guys have that, if you know what I'm talking about, and if you have that scent, please comment down below and tell me, how do you like it? How does it smell throughout the day? Is it too like much? Because I hate scents that's too much. I do not want to be that girl walking past somebody and they're like, oh my gosh, she literally drowned herself in the fragrance girl, but I'm obsessed right now and I've been actually loving it. Another thing with this fragrance, I love the fact that throughout the day, it's still there. I don't have to constantly reapply it. Even when I take off my wig, girl, cause I do spray my hair. So when I take off the wig and put it back on, I can still smell it just a little, not too much, but it's just, it's perfect for me. I love this. So this is something I'll definitely be constantly repurchasing right with my Gucci Guilty, cause y'all know I live for a good Gucci Guilty, girl. All right, now what would this list be without a pair of sunglasses? You girls know I am a shady girl. I love the shades, honey. And right now I am obsessing over my Gucci sunglasses. Look at that purple. I absolutely love purple, y'all know that. So these shades, y'all, they're so good, so good. Okay, I don't know the name of them. If I can find the name, I'm gonna link it down below. I don't know. Oh, they're a little dirty too. As you can see, that it's like a transparent lens and they're this beautiful brown with gold hardware. But let me just show y'all what they look like on. Oh, look at this. Look at the side handle. They're just so good. This is good for the season. Like, I absolutely love, love, love. Now, I got these because I was really wanting the Tom Ford pen sunglasses, but y'all know they sold out everywhere and I could not find them. So I found these at, not Sunglass Hut, the other one. I think it's Sosa's, something like that. It's not Sunglass Hut, it's the other one. And I was like, oh, these are so good. Anything that's oversized, but I really fell in love with like the vintage style handle on the glasses. I thought that was so cute that they decided to bring it down and just give it a little more character, girl. Like, oh, I love this for G. So, so pretty. And anything that I can still see my eyes through the frame, I absolutely love it. I love the detailing. I think it's so, so perfect. And I don't know if you can see, look how thick those lenses are. Just so cute. They're not flimsy. They are a little heavy, but I live, girl. So I have definitely been wearing these with everything. Everything. And these are just gonna be my fall shades. Of course, I do not mind bringing out the black shades, but I love a sunglass that's kind of transparent where you can still see my eyes and see what she's giving, what she's serving the peoples. So I definitely wanted these. This is also a great pair of sunglasses to have in a collection or something similar to these, because you can still pull these out in the spring, the summer. This is kind of like an all year round type of sunglass. They just go perfect with everything. This is like a must have staple in the wardrobe, and I'm so happy I finally got some, because the funny thing is I don't even have anything like this. And look at that, just so, so, so pretty. So I'm obsessing over them, girl. All right, now moving into the pieces that I don't have here with me. These are the pieces that I'm just kind of like manifesting into the wardrobe. But of course, I'm going to go ahead and put a picture on the screen so you girls can see the vision, okay? Okay, so first are the Louis Vuitton boots. I'm not quite sure the name of these boots. I really don't even care, but I just know, like, oh my God, I absolutely love these boots. I probably love these boots more than I love the Givenchy Shark Lock boots. These boots just scream G. They still have so much character, so much personality. I love the short ones. I love the tall ones. I love how they're so different and unique. They have so much detailing and different contrast on these boots, and every time I see them I just gasp for air. I went to Louis Vuitton literally the other day to see if they had them. As soon as I walked in, she was like, are you here for the boots? I forgot the name she called them. And I was like, yeah. She was like, girl, we don't have them. I'm like, oh, you know what, this is something that I'm not really rushing to get at the moment because I know I'm going to get them. I believe these boots start off, I saw them on the website, the short ones were $2,300, but they were sold out. So if the short ones are $2,300, I'm guessing the tall ones may be between $2,500 or $2,700. I'm not really sure. With these boots, this is a boot that I know I'm gonna have in my wardrobe. I do not care if I get them 5 years from now, 5 months or 5 days, I'm gonna have them. Like, that's just on period. These boots could be way out of style, out of season, I don't care. I want them, okay? They're just so good and they just scream G. I could just see myself with a nasty coat on and a pair of these boots. Chef's kiss. Now, if I'm being picky, I would love a pair of the tall, and I would also love a pair of the short. Now, on the runway, when these boots, when I first saw these boots, I saw these boots 2020. Yeah, last year, and I posted them on Instagram. They were not in production yet. And on the runway, these boots came in so many different colors. I'm not sure if they made all of the colors go into production, but a lot of the boots that were on the runway were just so fabulous. If you guys probably should be seeing some on the on screen. They just were so good. And girl, I just cannot wait till I have a pair. Okay? Okay. I can't wait. All right, so next I have a few items from Prada. I was never a big Prada girl, but right now I am feeling Prada. I love what they're putting down. Everything they're putting down, I'm picking up, and I'm just absolutely loving it. Now, when I was in Houston, I was obsessing over this Prada bucket hat. I still loving it. I go in the store and they had one in stock. So I literally pick it up and I'm like, okay, I want it. But I was like, okay, Jerenica, you're being very impulsive. Slow down. Try the hat on. I put the hat on my head, girl, and it did not fit. And I know if I wouldn't have had my wig on, the hat would have fit. But let's be realistic. I always have on my wig and I need something that's gonna also, I can also wear with a wig. Now, I know it's because with my wigs, I always add hair into the wig. So it's just giving it a little much. Girl, the hat literally set on the top of my head. I was heartbroken, okay? I had already pulled myself together to be like, okay, I'm gonna pay this price for a hat. Because I believe this hat is like $1,200 or $1,300. And I think that is just crazy. But when I saw it in person, it is just to die for. I literally gasped for air. And I just, me and the sales associate in the Houston Galleria store, we just had a moment, girl. We had a moment. It was a moment. But the good thing is she did tell me that the hat does come in large. However, in the whole Prada system, they only had one large. And that one was in France. And most likely, it was gone. But I am definitely obsessing over this hat, and as soon as I can get my hand on it in a large, I want it. I want it in green. I feel like, okay, of course the black will look so good in my wardrobe because I have so much black, but that green is just fun, and I may change my mind because I can't lie, when I saw the black too, I just was like, damn, it's just too good. All right, moving right along. Next, I have on this list a pair of Prada loafers. I want these loafers so bad. I think these loafers are so cute but ugly at the same time, and I'm just here for it. I tried these shoes on, and if you are looking to get these shoes, I would suggest going up a size. I tried these shoes on. I'm a normal 39 in European sizes, but the 40 fit me best. I did not pull the trigger and get these shoes because I wanted to wait until I know for a fact that I really wanted them. Yeah, I've really been obsessing over these shoes, but I did not go ahead and purchase them because I wasn't sure if I'm just like loving them or if I was just loving them in the store in the moment with the outfit I had on, because it looked really good with the outfit that I was wearing that day. But I was like, okay, if I purchase these, will I actually get my cost per wear? And at the time, I could not answer the question, so I left them, and maybe we'll revisit purchasing these in the future. Next on this list, I have something that I'm so excited to talk about because I'm actually wearing it more now, and it is my Balenciaga Shearling clutch. Now, with this bag, I purchased this bag, I feel like forever ago, and I don't wear it. And that's why I say I'm just tired of buying things and feel like I'm collecting them, but I'm not actually wearing them. So this year I've really forced myself, and I'm forcing myself to actually wear my things. And I think it's also hard for me because in my closet, y'all, I don't have like a walk-in closet, so I can't see everything. But anyways, this bag is just amazing. Like, it has been going so well with every single outfit. It looks good with my coats. It's everything that I just love. And every time I wear it now, it reminds me, okay, this is why I purchased it. This is why I purchased this bag. This bag came out in maybe 2016, 2017-ish, and I'm loving it. I absolutely love it. I got it in the black and white colorway. The most of the bag is the black with the white lettering, and they also have one with the whole bag is white with the black lettering. I chose not to get that one because I knew it would get dirty and all the things. But this bag has just been a great staple in my collection. It has been giving everything a pop. Even what I have on right now, it will look so good with this. But I wore it a couple times. I feel like I'm pulling it out more now, but I can't wait to wear it more when the seasons begin to change. But girl, she's been giving. Next on this list, I also have a few bags. I don't really feel like getting up to get them, but I'm gonna just go ahead and post pictures on the screen for you. And it is my Goyard St. Louis tote. Now, with these totes, I get so many questions every time you guys see me post it. I used to own the blue in the size PM. I ended up selling it because I wore it for about 3 years. I was over it, and I think I was more over it because I didn't like the PM size. For me, the PM size was a little on the small side. When I traveled, the bag just looked super bulky. It was not flattering, and I don't know, it just wasn't giving. I wanted it to be kind of oversized and be an actual tote that I can just put things in, travel if I need to, go to the gym, run errands, and still have room without the bag looking so bulky and just sloppy. So now I have this bag in the size GM, and I purchased it in the yellow and I purchased it in orange. Absolutely loving these bags. I travel with these bags. I wear these bags to the gym. This is kind of like lately have been my everyday bag. I think it makes my outfits look so cute. I was originally thinking about getting the green, but now I think I want to add the green into the collection, and after I get the green, I won't buy any more of these totes. But I'm kind of like right now going back and forth with the yellow and the orange, and I have just been crazy obsessing over these bags. Like, so chic, so cute, and I feel like right now I'm really on a Goyard kick. So I've been obsessing over these two bags. Now, last but certainly not least on this list, you guys know here on the channel I am a platform girl. I live and love platforms, but lately I've been seeing all the fashion houses, they've been bringing out more platforms and they're doing such a good job. So I'm back. Well, I don't think I've ever stopped obsessing over platforms, but right now I am crazy about platforms. They just so good. Marjorie Harvey, Steve Harvey's wife, my girl have been killing the platforms, girl. She have been bringing the girls out. Okay, she had on this gold pair, I believe it was Valentino platforms, and they are sickening. Okay, sickening, baby. She was giving the people what they need and what we do not deserve, because her looks, they just, she does it, okay? And I think another reason I'm more into platforms right now, because most of my boots and the shoes that I wear in the fallish time is all platforms. So right now I'm kind of slowly bringing out my boots, and I'm just like, oh my god, these platforms are just, they just giving me the life that I need. Now, one pair of shoes that I just ordered, and I'm just crossing my fingers that they work for me, you guys know right now Versace is really doing the platforms justice. They are doing it, okay? So they have this pair of like platform, it looked like a penny loafer, but it's in a platform style. You should be seeing it. And I want it in either the shoe, but I just ordered the boots. Now I'm hoping the boot can fit me, because I got it in a size 39 and a half, knowing dang well, you know, I cannot fit 39 and a half boots, but I'm praying that this works for me. So these boots are so good, girl. They're so sexy. They remind me of the Saint Laurent Billy boot, but I feel like these have more character, more chunk, more like personality, more volume, more zhuzh, and it's my zhuzh. I needed these, so let's just cross fingers, hope that I can fit them, because I love them. I like how they come sleekly up the thigh, well, not the thigh, the leg, kind of like, not even mid-calf, like slightly above the ankle, a little more above the ankle. But these, y'all should be seeing it. This shoe is too good, and I just need it. And I'm also loving their platform Medusa heads shoes that you guys are all seeing. They have them in yellow, orange, red, and black. Ugh, the girls have been just pulling out the platforms, girl, and I'm just living, okay? All right, girl, so that wraps up this list. These are all the things that I have been obsessing over, and even talking about them, it just makes me so happy. Comment down below and let me know what you're obsessing over, what you purchased, what you have in your closet that you pulled out and you're obsessing over. I want to know, okay? Don't leave me hanging, girl. So until then, I will see you girls in the comments, and I will also see you in the next video.